إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فإن خير الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. My brothers and sisters, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may Allah give us sincerity to speak the truth in the light of the Quran and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to understand them, to accept them in our hearts, and to implement them in our life. Today, inshallah, according to the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is in Sahih Bukhari in different books of ahadith, where Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, "Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli," pray as you see me praying. Inshallah, I will be giving you the description of the Eid prayer, and it is your choice. There's no compulsion. You take it or you reject it. It's your prayer. You have to give the answer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I'm going to give you from the Quran and the Sunnah how the Prophet has prayed his Eid prayer, and it is your choice to verify, check it, go back to the books, go back to the references. Alhamdulillah, if you find it that it is accordingly what I have said from the Quran and Sunnah, take it. Otherwise, it's your choice. And at the same time, I'm not here to give you the fatwa that those people who are praying in different manner, their salah is invalid. It is their responsibility. They should know. I'm not saying that it is invalid. It is up to them. Okay, and don't try to put the words into my mouth saying, okay, what about these people? The millions are praying like that. So, alhamdulillah, you ask them, what about that? But as Muslims, it is our duty that we should follow the Quran and the Sunnah. As a Muslim, we have to follow Quran and Sunnah because we say, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. That means we believe in Allah, that Allah is the only authority to be worshipped, and Prophet Muhammad is the messenger. To worship Allah, we have to follow the messenger, and Prophet is the messenger, so we are following Prophet Muhammad. So today's khutbah is all about the description of Eid prayer as well as some etiquettes of a Muslim, how he should be celebrating his Eid, different than the Eid of the Kuffar and the disbelievers. The hadith which I have quoted, it is from Sahih Bukhari and it is reported by Abu Qulaba, and he said that Rasulullah said, "Sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli," pray as you have seen me praying, and this is found in Sahih Bukhari, and the number of the hadith is 406. Another hadith of Rasulullah which is reported by Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, and he reports from his father, "Salatul Fitri rak'atan wa salatul Adha rak'atan. تمام غير قصر على لسان محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وقد خاب من افترى." This hadith is from Irwa al-Balil, authenticated by Shaykh Nasruddin al-Bani, volume 3, and the number is 683, where Rasulullah has said that the Eid rakat, the rakat for the Eid al-Fitr, that is Ramzan Eid, and rakat of Eid al-Adha, which is the Qurbani Eid, are only two rakat, and they are complete. Like we have Zohar four rakat, this is complete four rakat. Maghrib we have three, Isha we have four. So same thing, Eid rakat are two rakats and they are complete. And Abdullah bin Umar and Umar bin Khattab, they both are saying that the one who lies upon Rasulullah, he has destroyed himself. Which means, in this hadith we get an information that the rakat of Eid are two. Alhamdulillah. Another hadith of Rasulullah, which is reported by Aisha Siddiqa radiallahu ta'ala anha. Okay, just to bring to your notice, the word here is Salatul Fitri rak'atan and Salatul Adha rak'atan. The word Adha, if you ask anybody in Arab world, Adha is the day when you slaughter the animals. And that is the day of Eid. Now, day before yesterday, or 2 days ago, I was discussing with one of the learned scholars belonging to Hanafi group. He's a learned man, alhamdulillah, I respect his knowledge. And when I sent the text to him saying that, now take this point very clearly, when I sent the text saying that the Hujjaj, they will be celebrating their Yawm al-Arafah on Monday, and the next day will be Yawm al-Nahr for them, and Yawm al-Adha will be for us, quoting the same quotation, which means that if the Arafah is for the Hujjaj, the high pilgrims, is on Monday, and the next day will be Yawm al-Nahr, where they have to do four issues, the same day, the 10th day will be Eid for us. And this man, because he is following another calendar, because he is following another day, so what did he say? Look his answer, a scholar, a learned man. And he said to me, Sheikh Saab, where it is mentioned that you have to celebrate the Eid immediately after Arafat, the next day of Arafat? Which means he is saying, even though if it is Arafat on Monday or Tuesday or Wednesday, but where it is mentioned that you have to celebrate Eid the next day of Arafat? I sent the text to him saying, okay, you tell me which day should we celebrate the Eid. Is it Yawm al-Adha, it is Yawm al-Nahr, or it is Ayyam al-Tashriq, or which day? And he didn't reply. So, this shows that how people are blindly following the scholars, learned people, still they are following blindly the other opinions without going back to the Quran and Sunnah. So, coming back to this issue, because the word Adha is very clear that it has got nothing to do with the Hujjaj. It is for those who have not gone for the Hajj, for them the 10th day is called Yawm al-Adha because we do Adahi, we do the Qurbani. And for the Hujjaj who are there, they are doing the Hajj, for them the 10th day has got a different name and that is called Yawm al-Nahr. Because they do their Qurbani and Tawaf and they do their Halaq and everything on the 10th day. So Yawm al-Nahr because they also do their Qurbani on the 10th day, but that day is named for them as Yawm al-Nahr by Rasulullah, and those who have not gone for Hajj, for them is Yawm al-Adha, and that is the 10th day. Regarding Arafah, Rasulullah has said that the Muslims who are on the Arafah, when they are spending their time Wukuf al-Arafah, at that time because they are travelers, they are fasting is haram for them. But for us who have not gone for the Hajj, for us we have to fast on the day of Arafah because it will expiate the sins of 2 years, the year that has passed and the following year. This is what Rasulullah has said. Now, coming back to this point, if we consider that their sighting of the moon of the pilgrims in Haram, if it is wrong, that means millions of Muslims who are performing their Hajj, and Prophet said, Al-Hajju Arafah, Al-Hajju Arafah, Al-Hajju Arafah, that the Arafah is the essence of the Hajj. If they are wrong, that means we are declaring that their Hajj is invalid. And no, a common sense, yes, but.
Sorry, I want to ask you a question, Jaysam. Because we contacted two different masjids, regarding the issue. Because as you're aware, there's two Eids being celebrated next week, one on Tuesday and one on Wednesday. In two different masjids, we've got two different answers. In one masjid, they've said that the Imam has said that Eid is on Wednesday, and that's it. And we've asked the justification of that. There's no justification, it's just that the Imam has announced Eid for Wednesday. The other masjid has said, basically, when approached on the phone, we asked him that obviously we were informed that Hajj would be on Monday, so therefore, how are you celebrating Eid on Wednesday? And the answer we got was, that's happening there.
Okay, that's happening there.
That's happening there, and we said, well, therefore, whether how do you justify celebrating Eid on Wednesday? And they said, well, we started the moon a day later. So, can you shed some light on that?
Okay, alhamdulillah. This is what I'm explaining to you, my brothers and sisters, that in the month of Hajj, when it comes to Ramadan, yes, Ramadan has to do with the people who are sighting the moon, and Prophet has clearly said that, Sumu حين يصوم الناس. This is one hadith. And صوموا لرؤيته وافطروا لرؤيته. That see, start your Ramadan with the sighting of the moon and break your Ramadan and celebrate your Eid with the sighting of the moon. That is, فإن أغمي عليكم فعدوا 30 شعبانا. This is what Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. If in the, when you're looking for the sighting for Ramadan and if the sun is, the moon is hidden behind the clouds, then you count Sha'ban as 30 days and the next day will be Ramadan. So that is very clear because we know, alhamdulillah, that it has to go, it has got nothing to do with the people going for Hajj. It is the people everywhere where they are celebrating Ramadan. But when it comes to Hajj, Hajj issues are all totally related to the Hajjaj, pilgrims. So the way they have cited, we have to follow all the other rituals accordingly. If you don't they consider their sighting as right sighting, then we are declaring in other words that their Hajj is invalid. And it is a very, very serious statement to say that the Hujjaj, millions of Hujjaj are going there, they have, their Hajj is invalid. So, why I'm saying that we have to follow that? Because there are certain guidelines given to us by Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Number one, he said that Al-Hajju Arafah. The Hajj is Arafah, which means that the essence of the Hajj, the pillar of the Hajj is Arafah. If a person has missed the standing, the wukuf of Arafah, his Hajj is invalid. So Prophet has made it compulsory for them that Al-Hajj Arafah, that your Hajj is incomplete if you don't have the wukuf of Arafah. Which means they have to be particular, they have to be specific for the Arafah, yes or no? And if they are wrong, their Hajj is wrong, invalid. So, if their Arafah is on Monday, then definitely they will not do, they will not celebrate Yawm al-Nahar on the 13th or 15th. Yawm al-Nahar is the 10th day. And after the 10th day, in Arabic, we have the other words for other 3 days, and they are called Ayyam al-Tashriq. Take my words. 9th day is Yawm al-Arafah in Arabic in the Hadith. 10th day is Yawm al-Nahar, which is that they are slaughtering the animal, they are stoning the jamrat, one big pillar, and they are shaving the head and they are doing the tawaf. Tawaf al-Ifadah. These are the four issues done on the Yawm al-Nahar. This is for the Hujjaj. It is not done on the 12th day, it is not done on the 11th day. 11th and 12th day they have to throw the stones or pebbles on three jamrat. The 10th day is only one jamrat. So this is how the issues related to it. Arafah is 9th day, Yawm al-Nahar is the 10th day, Ayyam al-Tashriq is 11, 12 and 13. And these are the days where Rasulullah has said that these are the days of Eid for us. So starting from Yawm al-Nahar, if Yawm al-Nahar is the 10th day for them and 9th is Arafah, so for us also the Arafah has to be 9th day, because Rasulullah said if you fast on the 9th of on the day of Arafah, your sins are of 2 years are expiated, it's removed. So if you are looking for Arafah, then Arafah cannot be the next day. Arafah is the day when they are celebrating Arafah, and that is the day which we have to observe the fast. The next day, Yawm al-Adha for us, that is the day of Qurbani, and that is the day of Eid. And there are clear ahadith where it says that the next day of Arafah is the day of Eid for us, the day of Adha for us, the day of Dhabiha for us, the day of Qurbani for us. So, based on this, my brothers and sisters, coming back to the conclusion, Hujjaj are celebrating Arafah on Monday, and the 10th day is Yawm al-Nahar. So we have to fast on Monday because it is not Eid for us, and we have to celebrate Eid on Tuesday. Now, people, they say, you people are Wahhabi, you people are blind followers of Saudi and all that. Alhamdulillah, we are not like that. We have the Quran and Sunnah, and if somebody wants to take it, otherwise, there are people like he said, somebody said there is no answer for that. The someone also deliberately said that the sighting of the Saudi is wrong. That means they are declaring it that the Hujjaj, what they are doing, their Hajj is invalid because their sighting itself is wrong. So these are the statements which I don't want. Alhamdulillah, now brothers and sisters, we will be praying Tuesday, inshallah, Eid over here, 8:30. You are most welcome if you want to come, alhamdulillah, or you want to go and pray on Wednesday, it's not a problem. But my request to all of you, don't be blind followers.
Yeah.